Hello everyone, in today's video we're going to talking about upgrading your laptop's graphic card. So now if you have a laptop, then definitely you will know that you cannot upgrade the hardware of your laptop, like the processor or graphics card. It's not so easy. But on the other hand, if you are using a desktop PC, then it's very easy. You buy whichever graphic card you want and then just plug it in your motherboard. So I hope you know that. But in a laptop, due to limited space within the case, it's very difficult, and also you do not have specific ports. So, but there is one thing called riser card, which looks like this. This is called the PCI slot. You plug your graphic card in here, and if you are using a desktop PC, you can see this port vertically or horizontally in your motherboard. You just directly plug it in using this pin. You move it and plug it in directly. But on the laptop you cannot see this port because it is too big to handle. There is no space available in your laptop's motherboard for that. Instead, it has something called mini PCI. If your laptop has Wi-Fi card in it, generally Wi-Fi and Bluetooth will be together paired in one single card. And that card will be plugged in to the mini PCI slot. It is 4 times smaller than this, meaning nearly it will be this small, and a Wi-Fi card will be plugged in it. So that is the only reason you can find a mini PCI slot in your laptop's motherboard. If you have a powerful PC and it has gigs of RAM, 8GB, 16GB, and it has a good processor, and also it has a good graphic card, then obviously you're not going to be using it all day. When it stays idle, it's a waste, right? Mining is one thing. See, I don't know exactly how it's done because I did not do it. You download some software for mining and let it run in your PC whole day. One thing is, you have to let your PC run for whole day, and whenever your computer is idle, it will use the idle resources. It will use your RAM and processors and graphics card to process its own things and then upload it to their server, and in return you will get money. Only one thing is, your computer consumes a lot of power, and you'll have to keep it on all day, so you'll earn money by it. And in your computer you'll have at least 2 slots minimum. Modern computers have 4 PCI slots also. So you actually use this riser card not for this purpose, like attaching it to a laptop. The original purpose is to use more than one graphics card in the same computer. So, and if you place it in your motherboard directly, more than one graphics card, you cannot have a space, means the 2 graphics card touch each other like this. So this acts like an extension box, I can say. You can keep it somewhere here up or somewhere here down, anywhere, and just attach a cable to it directly into your PCI port. So that's how that works. So this is my graphics card, and it's GeForce GT710, and these are the things I use for setting up the riser card. So this is how the graphic card looks like. It's GeForce GT710. So you plug this into the riser card, and then use these cables, and then plug it into your laptop's whatever you call Wi-Fi slot, or more precisely mini PCI slot. Actually, it's made to use it in your desktop PCs only for mining setups, as I said before. But we are going to be using this to the laptop, so there will be some compatibility issues. That's why I failed actually. So yeah, the whole setup looks like this. Then this port you can see here is for the power. Now the reason you need a separate and external power supply for your riser card is because actually the mini PCI port in your laptop is made for Wi-Fi cards, and it allows only that much power needed to run a Wi-Fi card, and they do not require a lot of power. On the other hand, these type of graphic cards require a lot of power because they do heavy processing to run games, and they get heated a lot. If they draw a lot of power from your motherboard, the circuit might get damaged and it overloads. So to avoid that, they have made another system. The input, I mean this port from your USB cable connects to a laptop, and the interface goes through this port. The power is drawn through a separate port called a power port. Therefore you need a separate power supply. If you use this in your computer, there is no problem, because computer supplies more power. It is made for using graphic cards, so there is no problem. On the laptop, it is made for Wi-Fi cards. Therefore, you'll need some extra power to run this GPU in that port. So you'll connect this power cable to GPU. I mean, power cable to the riser card, and then connect this end to a power supply. It is called SATA cable. It looks like this. If you see, get any power supply, you can see this type of ports in that, and you can connect this to that power supply itself, so that it draws power from there instead of taking all the power from the laptop and then damaging the motherboard itself. So again, that's one problem. If you are using it in a laptop, you will have to buy a new power supply for only for this purpose. And then finally, you plug this USB cable into this port here, and this end into this small adapter. I said you mini PCI, right? Mini PCI is of this size, is this small, and this is the small USB port. You plug this into this very carefully. See, the whole setup looks like this now. My graphic card, riser card, power supply I haven't plugged because it's too difficult to remove the power supply from that. And then this cable, USB cable, into your laptop's Wi-Fi port. So the hardware part is over till here. Then what you'll have to do is go into your laptop's BIOS. BIOS is what appears on the booting screen. Then you'll have to change the settings, because the laptop thinks that this is a Wi-Fi card, because actually by default Wi-Fi card is plugged into that mini PCI slot. So the laptop assumes this to be a Wi-Fi slot and uses Wi-Fi drivers for that slot. So yeah, it does not work. You'll have to change that manually, and for my laptop's BIOS version, I did not know how to do that, and then I stopped there. So if you are going to do this, I don't suggest you do this using this riser. There is another adapter itself called EXP GDC BEAST, and the link is given in the description. You can see and check it out. But that one's a bit expensive. It costs some 3000 rupees nearly. That's why I took this. This one costs only 600 rupees. But if you're going to buy EXP GDC, I can assure you that most of the times it works, because it's a well-known adapter, EXP GDC, and it's also called BEAST, by the way. And many people have done this before, and they have been successful, and also made tutorials. So yeah, if I get time, I'll try to do this experiment again, and if I success, I'll make a video. But right now, if you really want to do this for your laptop also, I'll suggest you EXP GDC BEAST itself. If you think that it's expensive and this one costs only 600 rupees, then again, it's a wastage only. It does not work. What will you do? The riser card is waste now, and the graphic card is okay, but I'll have to use that in my desktop PC now, because I cannot use it on the riser. It is not matching with my laptop's BIOS. So actually, I do not use my computer a lot, because I can do all my work in my laptop only. So for me, it's a waste. Of course, all of this setup does not fit inside your laptop, because it does not have a lot of empty space left inside that. This is so fat, it does not fit inside. And so what you have to do is, that's why this cable is made so long. That's why I told you it's just like an extension box. And what you have to do is keep this separately outside. The graphic card riser setup outside, along with this power supply cable and the power supply also. You'll keep all this setup outside and only this cable, USB cable, runs inside your laptop. So most laptops have a DVD writer on the bottom. So what you'll have to do is remove that DVD writer and keep it aside. Then you'll have to find a place inside where your Wi-Fi card is. Then plug this slot into that mini PCI port. Then it looks like this. This cable goes inside your DVD writer empty space. You have to keep the DVD writer outside. You cannot use it. You'll have to sacrifice it if you want to do this graphic cards upgrade. And then you'll use laptop normally. But yeah, you can see that one disadvantage is you'll have to carry all of this. If you want to use the extra graphic card upgrade, wherever you carry your laptop, you'll have to carry this whole setup with it because it is connected. It goes inside your DVD port and fits that. This thing is open. If anything falls on it, it gets damaged. See, it's a whole PCB circuit itself. These capacitors and they all get damaged. And one idea is you can find a good box or any case and keep that inside that. That's why I'm not recommending riser card for you. If you really want to do, use EXP GDC. It's much better than this. So for me, I'll be using laptop like this only. It has inbuilt integrated Intel HD graphics 3000. That's enough for me. Still, if I want to do some extreme graphic work, I'll do it in my computer. I'll plug this graphic card directly into that instead of all this riser card mess.